perfect outside. It's like God let me dial up the weather. Got the whole room, forever. It's one of those never forget it, better stop and take it in kind of scenes. Everything's just right, yeah, except for one thing. You should be.
Come on. I did not overdose. He made a choice to get high, not to die. If any of you knew my son, you would know that he loved life. He loved his friends. We got Jay over there that is wearing John's football jersey. Brought the girls to the Panthers. My son loved Tyler, my son loved Jay. He would do anything for anybody. Yet the individual who sold John a lethal dose of fentanyl, also known as his quote-unquote best friend, was connected back to Lucas and Wooddale's death, led off with murder charges because he ratted out 5 people from the west side of Chicago. After Lucas, he moved on to Phil from Carroll Street. At that point, when do we start enforcing the law since 1989 in Illinois for a drug-induced homicide? What if John's case was investigated properly and they charged the killer and he went to jail? Would it bring John back? Would it give us some kind of peace? No, there's neither one of those. But we do have to sit and think Lucas and Phil's family wouldn't be sitting there suffering in silence and pain if he was locked away, because they would still have their children. So it leads me to ask, why are drug dealers getting away with murder? As we stand here today with parents and family members from all other states, thank you so much for flying in and everything. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
I have to ask, where are the families from DuPage County? If there were 259 drug-related deaths in DuPage County, where are they? Why am I the only one standing up here? I need more parents. This is unacceptable. As society, we are so ignorant, and we hold this stigma. As family members, we are shut down with it's such an epidemic because nobody wants to talk about it. Right now, we have parents committing suicide because they can't deal with the pain from their loss. They have no one to talk to. Are we that selfish and self-consumed that we really can't shut up and just listen to someone and see where their heart is and what they're going through and help them get through a rough day, a minute, an hour, whatever it takes? So my challenge right now is to DuPage County. We love Carroll Street Police Department. We love DuPage County. I think that DuPage County needs to start a ripple effect on caring more, and we need to spread this out to Cook County. And this ripple effect needs to start an earthquake so the state of Illinois has changed and we're not losing an entire generation of our kids anymore. Right. Thank you all for
coming.
Thank
you, Kathy.